hardest things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you try to, you know, you understand that nothing.
Guys, before the game on, let's see how readiness of them. Okay, right here with me is Mr. Abhishek Sekhar, team manager from Mono Empire. Swadika. Okay, at first, I have to tell you that congratulations for your first winning in the league. Yeah, so this is make you very confident for this game.
Yeah, the first thing, Mono Empire, say hello to everyone. Swadika, Mono Empire, Swadika. Okay, the first game win, we get more confident. And we are really happy. Yeah. So this game, we will use that to this game for win. Okay.
We use the same plan or same tactic for this game, right?
Yeah. We have to use the experience from the first game. We lost them, so we have to learn, have to watch the video
and fix them.
Yeah, and fix them, and we have to rotate Thai player more than the first game.
Okay.
Play harder, defend harder.
Okay. So do you have any important guard in your hand or will you surprise us?
Yeah, I think the important guard is that we use a teamwork and we have to rotate player, Thai player to defend and get them because Freddy, he really good play. The first game we lost because Freddy, he really good shoot and really good play. Yeah. So today we have to defend him a lot.
You have to stop him.
Yeah.
So I have to tell Freddy that beware.
Yeah.
And thank you so much and have a good luck for tonight.
Thank you very much.
Okay. And next is Mr. Raham Motel from High Tech Bangkok City. Sawadika. How are you doing?
Okay.
You just have one more day from the last game for Tigray. So how is your players that we all can see that your players just very exhausted. How about them?
Well, we just review all our plays from yesterday, because we came from Division One like championship, and then we played. You can see some of the players were not active during that day, but we expect to see more actions today.
Okay.
Yeah, because we're a bit rested, although it's too short. Yeah.
Today you face with an important rival as the Mono Empire. So do you have a special, any tactic or any special things?
We just adjusted because we won them last time. So we just made additional adjustment on, especially on the one that's dominating the board, which is McLean. So we have to try to contain McLean today.
As we spoke before, that you have a new player, so will you send them on the court?
Well, right now, he's very young. He's only 18 years old, and we want to introduce him to the Thai community. That we also give chance to younger youth basketball players who are capable of playing at this level. Yeah.
Okay, we will see that, and have a good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Khop khun ka. So now get back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Victoria. Well, as during the interview, the coach of Mono said their game plan for today is more player rotations and harder defense, and hopefully you stop Freddy. So as we see the standings here, High Tech was handed their first loss last game by the Singapore Slingers, and Mono still in the sixth place. So will this be an upset if Mono wins?
I'd say it would be an upset, but not a completely big upset. Mono has shown that they are really competitive in this league. They only have, probably you saw, -3 point difference. So that means that they've been pretty much up par with anyone, but it's just a little bit of here and there that's made them fall down to the bottom of the standings, Joe.
Especially with the history that these two have gone through. Mono has defeated High Tech a couple of times in the local leagues as well, right?
Yeah, these two are pretty strong rivals against each other. They've been going back and forth. Each game has been come down to the wire. Players are playing with their emotions all the time. Everyone wants this game.
Well, hopefully High Tech will come out firing strong this game, especially during the last game. They had a back, well, they came from back-to-back games, Division One championship and then a heavy game against the Singapore Slingers. And now they come off a one-day rest, which with the way High Tech's been juggling these leagues is somewhat of a vacation and a luxury to them.
Yeah, the fatigue will play this game, obviously, but it's been their choice. They want to participate in all these leagues, and it's their competitive fire here that they've got to overcome this stretch.
Yes, well, it's pros and cons joining in several leagues. You get the experience factor in for your local players. All Victoria mentioned in the interview. High Tech added a new player. His name is Chanatip Jakrawan.
Yeah, raw, but from what we've seen him playing in the locals league, he's really tall. He's about 2 meters tall. He can play defense and he can really shoot the ball from the mid range. So that should help. Once he gets more experience and confidence in this league, he should be a really good rotation guy for the High Tech Bangkok City team.
So how do you think this new player is going to fit in with the High Tech system? Is he going to play more of a power forward, stretch four, or a dominant, like a big three?
Well, surely in the ABL, no vampires. He's pretty lean, so I see him more as a stretch four for High Tech, where I see him fit in the system.
He kind of is a younger resemblance of the player that he replaced, Danai Kong Kung. Both of them are pretty tall. How's his mid-range game?
His mid-range game is really good. Of course, not in the same level as Danai Kong Kung, whose mid-range game is on point. But yeah, he's more like a taller version, maybe more springy. The guy can really dunk it out there.
Yeah, well, hopefully the experience factor that he's going to receive from playing in the ABL will benefit High Tech in the long run, as a lot of their players aren't really that young anymore.
Yeah.
A lot of them have been playing in the leagues for a long, long time. Mono, on the other hand, is a mixture of both young and old. They have a bunch of veterans and they have a bunch of young guns.
Sure. Yeah, like you said, Mono, they're trying to mix in the youngsters and their veterans. Someone I really like from the Mono roster is the point guard Soro Tinton Siri. He's only 21 years old. He's getting a lot of playing time from the Mono Vampire coach, Brassert. He's really confident in using him. Off, he's had turnovers here and there, but he's been showing that he can score. He has speed to play in this league, Joe.
Yeah, I know Sorot actually played against. Now, the development that he has made and the development that Mono has done to him is amazing. He has
exactly what we're talking about. Coach Brassert has had the confidence to use him, and it's really paying right now. Like, the past 2 years, he's been playing a lot. Now he's playing with a lot of fire.
And here, just as we were talking, this is the new city.
There's his teammates from high school cheering him on.
A big crowd for the new player. Good welcome from the Thai fans. I think we're going to have a packed gym tonight, especially with these cross rivals.
Yeah, it should be. The crowd should be from both teams, who have not that much trouble traveling here, unlike teams from other countries, of course.
Yeah, definitely. Mentioned by the coach of Mono, they have to stop because, and remember, Mono, Freddy was the one that
0.7 assists, and that 10-point run in the middle of the third quarter of the fourth quarter really put High Tech up in front of that game.
Well, yeah, as we mentioned during the previous game against Singapore, when Freddie Goldstein came in, instead he made all these bunch of threes and bundles, we had to give him the nickname the Microwave, because he heats up so easily.
Yeah, he heats up really quick. You just can't let him get that rhythm into him. He's got to stop him before he gets that rhythm going.
Now let's talk about his partner in crime, Tyler Lamb. Tyler Lamb coming off a horrible game, let's say. Yeah. Well, in the last game, he was just struggling all over. So hopefully he gets his confidence back and he'll play pretty well today.
Yeah, hopefully he's going to come back from that game where he shot only 1 for 15. Last game against Mono Vampires, he scored 18 points. So yeah, it's not going to be another horrible night for him.
And with Tyler Lamb and Freddie Goldstein playing amazing tonight, if they do so, that's going to be a tough challenge for Mono Vampires. Well, folks, right now we're going to have the national for Thailand.
ประเทศไทยรวมฤทธิ์เนื้อชาติชื่อไทยรัฐพระไทยคงไทยทุกส่วนอยู่ดำรงคงไว้ได้ทั้งมวลด้วยไทยรุ่นหมายรักสมัครคีไทยนิรักสงบแต่ถึงรบไม่ขาด
There we just had the Thai national anthem. Now both teams are gonna shake each other's hands and say their hellos. Probably have a lot of smiles there because a lot of them know each other from playing together. Quickly talk about the keys of the ball game, TK. What does Mono need to do to defeat the defending champions?
Well, for Mono, they really need to control the boards. Last game that the High Tech Bangkok City lost to the Singapore Slingers, they were out-rebounded. So, yeah, the Twin Towers of Mono have really got to actually play at the same pace. They combined it for 34 points and 35 rebounds in their last game, so it shouldn't be hard. But if they are able to control the rebounds in this game, I don't see a problem.
But the problem would be Okoli and Christian Charles, because Chris Charles is an offensive specialist and Okoli is a defensive.
Kind of like seeing two opposites collide here.
It's going to be a pretty interesting matchup. Well, who do you think has the advantage between the two players?
I think, well, Chris Charles is more seasoned. He's been in this region for a long time. He pretty much knows how to pace himself. Sometimes you see Okoli going full pace at one time and he can't control himself in others. So I give Chris Charles a small edge. He knows when to go full stream and when to pace himself down a little bit.
Talk about the battle of the bigger Stephen Klein.
Yeah, two big guys going straight at each other, two stone hard to bang with each other.
McLean's so big that his nickname's
You have to be really, really big to have a nickname as big like that. And Steve Thomas, he's called Steve the Demon Thomas, which has really stuck with him throughout all this time. So two really cool nicknames going at each other.
Biggie. Stephen Thomas, the veteran, will probably get the upper hand. Although McLean has been proving his worth during the past few games, keeping Mono, you know, alive and competitive in that sense against the other teams.
So actually, the keys to the game for High Tech Bangkok City here, other than the inside play, will be their outside ball rotation. They've been doing not that bad in the first couple of games with their passing. Rack of assists, but in the last game against Singapore, Freddie Goldstein just sometimes stops, and he only was limited to two assists and five turnovers, and that kind of for High Tech Bangkok City.
I agree with you that the last game, we didn't really see that system we can have Sukhdev Gogar and the new guy, Chakrawan, getting some minutes against another Thai team. They're probably going to be familiar with the other players as well. We're getting ready for the tip-off.
Both teams are going with their usual lineups here. Not much change.
And we're going to start the ball game, folks.
And Moon Moon starting the game here at the point guard for the Mono Vampires.
By High Tech Bangkok City on that. You need to see
the ball.
By High Tech Bangkok City on their first possession, and this is what, you know, what we want to see. The High Tech Bangkok City that we know of.
That wasn't a bad shot. Ball here into Biggie. doesn't get inside.
I thought that was going to be a slam and jam by Okoli.
Almost. Klein takes a table. Once again, High Tech's going to set it up. Thomas going to take the line. Still fine.
Bit of a slow start for.
Slow finding way to break the offense.
Good defense there. Stolen by Ruben. Tyler Lamb!
Tyler Lamb with the jam there. That's his first dunk in the ABL. We haven't seen that athleticism yet from Tyler Lamb, but it's a good sign for High Tech here.
Hopefully that will increase the confidence of Tyler Lamb.
Ruben Klein gets inside. That's a big part of the defense that Ken really is able to play in the game.
A bit unhappy with that no call block by Christian Charles.
Still get the ball though. Bad pass there. Seemed like a bit of miscommunication early on here for Mono Vampires.
Mono Vampire can't really afford any careless turnovers in this game, especially against the defending champion.
That's been a problem that's been nagging them throughout the whole tournament. They're really turning for the whole team. They allowed 22 turnovers in that last game. It really hurt them even if they got the game.
Freddie Goldstein
heating up early in this game. Like I said, you don't want to get him into rhythm. High Tech going still with a man-to-man defense.
Tua, he's a known shooter.
Nice pass there from Freddie Goldstein to Tyler Lamb.
Good shot by Tyler Lamb. I thought he was going to slam it home once again.
High Tech go up to a 7-0 lead here. Mono Vampire still struggling to find out actually how to attack. He's only 10% outside. And maybe for Sleuthi tonight. A lot more movement off the ball, a lot more ball movement passing around. I really like what I see from the High Tech and Raycon City offense early on here, Joe.
Yeah, I agree with you. It's much better to watch right now than the previous game that they had against Singapore.
Clogging it up there in the paint, not letting any movements go by easily. There's always a body hitting up with the Vampires players who get into that shaded lane. And the Vampires shearing up.
High Tech in the ball game.
Yeah, but he's a bit slower, pushing that good with the good. But if you're gonna post up, you have Quincy Okoli and Anthony McLean in there, so there's not much space. High Tech, he's pushing out the points here.
That's a good tip in by Christian Charles, working the boards, aggressive, staying aggressive. That's good.
Gotta keep on the boards. Here's the start of the game. Traveling violation on Chris Charles, too many steps. Chris Charles has been a bit off in these past two games, so he should try to get some easy shots inside here.
Hopefully he gets his rhythm in this game, especially against the defensive shot with Quincy Okoli guarding him. First game, he was
down low. Is Charles going somewhere?
Oh, that was a good defensive stop by Biggie.
Nice pass there. Coley went a bit too strong there. Bunny missed there by Jerome Pyman. He gets the ball right back.
Boom! Makes it. Atakan Huang Boom. Good 3-point shot.
Just like that, the Vampires are within 5 points.
I think they count that as a 2-point shot rather than a 3.
Maybe
now by High Tech Bangkok City, 9-7. Yeah. Adjustments both coaches have made in the game. Hi-Tech with a great start, 7-0 run. And then Mono coming back with a mini run of their own. Score is 9-7.
Hi-Tech with the ball. See if they make any adjustments here. Setting up the two inside players high again. Ready going to his usual left side. The Hi-Tech Mecca stays still with the ball. Tyler gets him up.
Oh, put back by Christian Charles.
Another athletic move there by Tyler Lamb, but he wasn't able to seal the deal there.
Bit of a lucky possession there. They almost lost it, but Charles recovers it and passes back to Lamb.
But it's nice to see that Tyler Lamb's getting more aggressive in this game, even if he missed that time. Charles just goes full body.
He wants to jump the momentum. He can't stop the momentum going into the shooter.
The guy just takes the whole body in there. He's still on the floor.
Hopefully, Mong Boon is feeling okay. See the replay over here. Christian Charles pumps on the pump fake. Mong Boon should have just taken that shot right there. Would have been 3 free throws for him.
It's hard to stop.
Looks like he didn't jump on that jump shot.
And he's still feeling some of the effects of the injury. Christian Charles drive.
Dawson inside.
Dawson just seemed to freeze the Mono Vampire defense there. Nobody saw what was coming.
Dawson, another very athletic player for Hi-Tech Bangkok City.
Right now, what we're seeing is not really that much of what we saw last year. When we saw dunk and ball. He's getting there in the game, so maybe that's still holding up.
Yeah. Defensive stop once again by Hi-Tech.
That's off Rad Deck Curtiwa. And Hi-Tech gets the ball.
You can really see the fire in Hi-Tech Bangkok City's players. They really want to beat Mono Vampire tonight.
They really want to beat this game. It's going to be a heavy game for anyone who goes out with the win. Samur Jai is inserted in for Natakarn Mungu, who should be getting a little breather after that collision. Freddy with his patented floater, and he gets the friendly roll.
The lazy floater that we've been talking about.
Should have patented that name already, the lazy floater by Freddy Goldstein. Samur Jai setting up the ball. Looking for options here. He's not getting much. Trying to show Blaha. He wants to see the steal.
Dasom!
Dasom is being a difference maker early on in this game. As we mentioned, he didn't play in the last game. So here he is running the fast break and making the cuts. Something that Hi-Tech might have missed from last time.
Definitely. Beautiful start by Hi-Tech Bangkok City, especially defense.
Suddenly they're up by 10 again. It's Hi-Tech ball.
Another defensive stop by Hi-Tech Bangkok City.
Good job of Steve Thomas and Chris Charles swarming Anthony McLean in the post. Not letting him get easy looks inside. More ball movement here from the Hi-Tech. Chris Charles inside. He's working the post. Nice pass there, but couldn't finish it off.
Beautiful cut there by Steven Thomas. And Freddie Goldstein.
The microwave is heating up here, Joe.
Instant offense by Freddie Goldstein.
Score is eerily similar to the score that they trailed Singapore Slingers in the last game. Seems like someone picked up a foul on Samur Jai here. Should be Freddie Goldstein with the reach in the back.
The foul. 2 free throws for Anthony McLean.
Chris Charles with a hard foul there on Anthony McLean to prevent the and one. See that again in slow motion.
McLean clearing out some space.
Big body going around.
Really good to see Anthony McLean go up against a guy like Stephen Thomas. Thomas isn't somebody that you can push around either.
It's going to be good experience for him to go up against a guy like Thomas. Plain is still pretty relatively young in the 30s.
Yes.
Plain is around 27, 28.
Yeah, around 27 years old.
Actually, he just turned 28 late last month. Happy birthday. Happy belated birthday.
Belated Anthony happy birthday to Anthony McLean.
Misses both free throws, however, so kind of jinxed it. The
score is 19-7 with a minute to go in the first quarter.
Slow offense. It's a shaky summer time there.
He has a killer crossover. Goldstein with another floater.
He's just firing up right now. Goldstein has at least 9 points here in the first quarter, and that's what Coach Abichoksako, manager Abichoksako, was warning them about not letting Freddy Goldstein get his game. And Leon, that's not doing well. So that's Klahan with the basket.
Klahan, another local with a big body. He used to play for High Tech Bangkok City as well.
Actually, he played in the ABL for High Tech Bangkok City last year. For half of the season.
Where he was replaced by a sharpshooter, Patrick Kabahu. Tyler Lamb for three, finally!
Everyone is firing all cylinders here.
Let's see if that can increase his confidence. Wow, that's a far three by Kuratila.
Kuratila wanted that back at him. A hell of a first quarter here for High Tech, going up by 15 points. They really excelled on the offense there, Joe. Like, not.
In the ball game, folks. If you've just joined us, we have an exciting cross-country matchup between the rivals, High Tech Bangkok City and Mono Vampires. High Tech Bangkok City coming off a blazing start in the first quarter, going up 24-9. They've been clamping down on defense, showing the High Tech offense. Great passing, good ball movement. What adjustments does Mono have to do in the second quarter, TK?
Right now, they can't really do much except add more pressure to the scorers, to the shooters, because High Tech's just hitting everything they give. So you just got to push up that pressure, maybe give some fouls away a bit. Just got to miss.
That's a good point. Make High Tech earn their baskets. They've been getting easy layups. Dossum, Lamb, even Charles getting the putback rebounds. Okoli.
We're seeing an early entrance. Chris Charles, he actually didn't play that much in those last games, so Coach Jing is really showing confidence in his local players here.
Yeah, definitely, especially when you're up 24-19. Let's see if Gogar can handle Quincy.
drive in, but he doesn't get the pass to Anthony McClain. The Mono Vampires have been digging a little bit deeper into the bench than the High Tech Manhattan City team. They've only made two subs already. So let's see if that plays on in the fatigue in the later stages of the game. Maybe they make another substitution on Q, bringing in Pirat Sektira for Jonathan Blahan.
Sektira, a really good slasher and a high leaper as well.
And they're trying to get the ball inside with a nice closeout. Samurjai with a
pump layup over there. Well, if you are Mono Vampires and you see Chris Shaw sitting in the bench, you would stay much more aggressive, challenging Sukdev Gokar. And a turnover there by Freddy. And Samurjai gets the layup.
Samurjai being a spark plug here for Mono Vampires, scoring four straight points to start the quarter. The horns up at the top.
Goldstein!
Goldstein still firing up everything. He's now in 5 or 6 shots. This is not the kind of game that the Mono Vampires. Resting a lot of players early on here for Coach J. See if it pays off. Jai using his footwork to work out there. He's been really attacking the basket, Hondo. Decision.
Turnover. Pass wasn't handled. Samurjai, although he's actually a really good passer.
He's a really good passer, really good ball handler as well. Really flashy point guard.
Yeah.
Gave with the ball.
Nook tries.
Inside. Arun again with a three. Can't hit it.
Yeah, Arun, 0-for-2 in this ball game to start.
Your High Tech Bangkok City.
Because if you take them out right away, right now, they might lose confidence. It might affect you throughout the whole season.
For the best call.
Except Thomas to carry his team right now.
That's a big.
The momentum went back to Samurjai and he just flew off Stephen Thomas.
Here's something you were talking about, Coach James Bogar, after 3 minutes of the play. Sukdev hasn't been playing that much. I really have to worry about him about taking him out, but actually show what he's capable of. But let's see what the coach thinks. Charles.
It is a bit understandable. Aha! Wraps Charles.
The ref's call here.
Jump
the ball.
And scuffle head on the floor. A bit understandable. Put him to the three position. Play a really big lineup. One guard at the three and Charles. Thomas, but once Charles or Thomas needs a breather, what is your go-to
back? They scored only 2 points in the first quarter here, still looking for more of that flow they found in the first. Cortez and Oak not finding it there.
Another fast break from Mono.
Mono
is so rocked.
Mono has been really running it out. High Tech has struggled to get back on defense.
Run of their own at the beginning of the second quarter as we have a timeout 6-17.
Okay. Stop ball, stop ball.
Okay.
Okay. Sacrifice, sacrifice. That's 6 points.
Okay.
So we will run early offense, okay? Now Steve got the ball here. Your man sagging here. Show you up here.
Hey, watch out. Watch out. Watch out. We are hooked.
And we're back from the timeout. As we've heard in that timeout session, Coach Junior Ruiz asking his boys, the guards especially, to go back down on defense right away, be a safety, and just rely on Steve or Chris Charles to get the rebounds. He doesn't want to give up any more fast break points.
That was interesting to see how Coach Jim was infuriated out of that timeout. Not a really common picture to see. We're going aggressively inside, but gets the turnover out of it.
Coach Jim Ruiz not taking any chances. That's why, even if he is up by a margin, he still doesn't want the lead to go down. See the replay here.
Smacked in the face there.
Well, two players coming in. That was Bahan and Okoli contesting Pia Pong Kruboon.
Coach James puts in his starting lineup now. He's avoiding any chance of an upset here. He's been conservative. Okoli taking the James jumper.
Coach Samuel Palmer down. He's head coach right now. Always the assistant of Jellybean Bryant, right, TK?
Yeah. So it's really good to see him actually get that chance. I really like Coach Sen as a player development coach. He really loves to see his players go up in front of his eyes. And it's really good to see him actually get the wins, control the development of players himself, and use him as he imagines his system.
I was actually under the Coach Sen system. When I first got here in Thailand, I played for Coach Sen. I'm pretty familiar with the way that he runs his teams, and he's actually a really good hands-on coach.
Yep, the players are showing up for him this season.
Oh, now we see Sukhdev Gogar back in the lineup.
Coach Jing rotating his players a lot here. Trying to find the perfect combination. Tyler Lamb with a three. And
oh, Tyler Lamb!
Tyler Lamb still on fire here. Ready Golsey and Tyler Lamb rebounding from that last game. Well,
both carrying the load right now for High Tech Bangkok City.
He is still in double digits for High Tech. So let's see, diving. Mid-range jumper here from the one time.
Goldstein draws the foul.
Moments back. Set up with 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Nice pass.
Oh.
Multi pong dash. Not exactly good. Still loving the ball. The ball move. So.
Back to the ball game, folks. Possession is with Mono Vampires.
One interesting thing here is that High Tech actually haven't got any chances in the free throw line yet. Oh, their aggressiveness could be something that they can do.
Oh, yes.
Anthony McClain goes strong there.
See, the coach of Mono fired up.
Anthony McClain has to be strong here. He only has 2 points off 1 of 4 shooting here. that's not going to be acceptable for the Mortal Vampires if they want to pull off this game.
Yeah, their offense is heavily relied on Anthony McClain playing big. He needs to be more aggressive, I guess, get more touches down low.
Biggie gets a free throw here. That is attempting the second one.
This is the second, but Okoli gets the offensive rebound.
So good. Starting at the offense. Nice spin move.
A spin move by Sorok Suntansiri.
Anthony McClain gets a rebound. Matakar Mungu making his way back into the game after that hit. Wide three. McClain. All the Vampires are getting more active on the boards, and that's what you want to see going up against the High Tech Bangkok City team here.
More aggressiveness as well. Trying to match the energy of High Tech Bangkok City. Natakan Muang Boon and Khanat Samar Jai. They're very different players. Muang Boon, the veteran, steady point guard. Samar Jai, the flashy quick star of Mono. As we see the steal and a fast break.
We're starting to see some fire here from the Vampires on defense.
Play over here.
See what happens here. We're gonna get a pretty good view of this.
That was a good block by McClain, by the way.
Nice pass there from Sorod.
And I agree with Darun Pan. He got hacked on the arm. I guess the referee didn't catch that.
Darun Pan has a tendency of calling for all shots. So the refs are a bit wary of that. The High Tech Bangkok City are going for early offense here. See if they can get back to moving the ball more, which got them the big lead in the first race, which is down to 8 points now. 2 minutes left into the first half. The Vampires steadily getting to the floor.
For something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop.
Make your own way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, with that youth. and you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that someone come to your school or see someone care about your life. I get it.
So we're heading out into the second half here. The first half, we saw both teams pretty much with their foul move on the second quarter. They just locked it down on defense. They tried to not foul anyone, and it paid them when they got the fast breaks going out.
Oh, yeah. That was a good comeback by Mono Vampires in the second quarter to get back in the ball game. High Tech, actually thought it was going to be a breakaway game throughout if High Tech kept the tempo, but with Chris Charles in foul trouble and Mono Vampire finding their groove, we have a ball game once again. Score is 32-29, High Tech Bangkok City up as we're about to start the second half. Coach Jing Ruiz giving out final instructions to his players. Let's see what adjustments both coaches have made in the locker rooms. Probably High Tech Coach Jing Ruiz telling his players to continue to play the way they have. Keep staying aggressive. Don't let your foot off the gas pedal. And for Mono, try to find out the same groove that they have in the second quarter continued throughout the ball game. It should be an interesting matchup in the second half with the adjustments that both coaches are going to make.
A changing point in the second quarter, I felt, was that maybe Jing Ruiz started out the second quarter with a bit too many substitutions, and High Tech sort of lost their rhythm, their momentum from there. And by the time we changed in their starting lineup back in, it kind of went already too much out of reach. But now they come out of the halftime break, and maybe they can start it up again and run away with the lead again.
Yeah, I agree with you with that. especially just leaving in Stephen Thompson taking four out of five starters and then expecting the whole bench to continue the momentum, although, you know, none of them are Freddie Goldstein.
That with the mic today.
Goldstein.
And that's what I'm saying on the perimeter. Chris Charles back in the game. He's looking for his offense here.
Chris Charles, early offense.
Starts early in the second quarter with 2 points. Mono Vampire is going to look for a way to respond here. Going to be fielding Rohan at the guard, and they have Ratte Kirtiwa back in the game. On cue there, he gets the ball. Rohan has been showing his shooting range here. He's made a lot of shots from mid-range. Not exactly his usual type of game where he just slashes and gets fouls.
He's got the confidence going right now.
Fouls with the ball again.
Charles short on that.
Anthony McLean with a big rebound there.
Kirtiwa for three.
That's what we were talking about, that we can't let, high-tech can't let the Mono Vampires get going. It's a 3-point shot.
Kirtiwa ties the ball game.
Kirtiwa is just love shooting against high-tech.
Against anyone.
Anyone does. Charles starting down low. Kirtiwa down some again. Playing around with Kirtiwa. Nice drive and dish. Gets
Christian Charles with the end one.
Nice cut there by the what's he called, Dazong, and he found Chris Charles with the drive there.
It was a good drop pass by Mono's defense. Unlike Singapore in the previous game, they've been hounding and collapsing on Chris Charles.
That's a nice pass there. Chris Charles slowly finding his offense here. Let's just hope that he doesn't pick up the fourth foul to disrupt the momentum that high-tech might be gaining here. The Vampires set up again. Let's see if they can get Kirtiwa for another shot. And I feel like if Kirtiwa gets the ball, he's going to have a huge check to his
moment. Boom, boom, on the other hand, misses.
Ball goes around, it's jungled, and
Mono retains possession.
He retains possession, yeah.
I really like Kuzo Okoli's haircut.
Maybe something else. It's like three little caterpillars on there. You see there, the heat check we're talking about, and doesn't make it.
And high-tech gets the possession. McLean doesn't really agree with that call.
Ball up. Good drive again. Still struggling to finish at the rim.
Good shot. Shot block attempt by Okoli to bother Dasum's layup.
Inside. Nice finish there. Where did that come from?
What a
from?
Move by Darumpan.
A bit of smirk on his face. The Vampires within 1 point now. Charles looking for his offense. Steve Thomas. Gets Tyler on the three. Doesn't hit it this time.
Charles with the offensive rebound. And a putback.
Tyler Lamb loves those putback rebounds.
Kirtiwa.
Another heat check charge. Doesn't take it. That's the thing about Kirtiwa, though. Once he makes one shot, he's going to feel it for another three or four shots. And if you're a team that he's on, you've got to live through that. Sometimes he'll make it, sometimes not. This time he doesn't, though.
It's both his gift and his curse, the three-point shot, especially with the decision-making he's been doing in this past three possessions.
And it's in, and 3 points up by high-tech. Nice pass there by Steve Thomas. Doesn't
almost
get the shot.
Almost rolling in. Tyler Lamb, though, able to draw the foul, so he's going to be awarded 2 free throws.
High-tech has been attacking the basket more aggressively. We were talking about halftime about how high-tech wasn't getting any free throws. And now suddenly they're getting in ones and they're getting free throws here and there. That's really something that
a good aggressive play by high-tech Kangal City. Although in the first half, a bunch of the layups that they have been making were actually open layups.
Yeah.
lead to 5, 41-36. 7 minutes to go. Well, under 7 minutes to go.
Shane takes out Curtiva after those two checks. Maybe one of the
Curtiva's still in the game. Still. Yeah.
Sekatira trying to drive, turns the ball over. Has it done with a fast break?
Bad decision by Tyler Lamb, especially when Okoli's right there. And Okoli blocks, but Christian Charles with a tip in.
Ill advised passing there for Tyler Lamb, but in the end, it ends up in 2 points anyway.
Defense right there.
Igor working Tyler Lamb. Passes around. 5 seconds on the shot clock.
The
Tech settling down there.
Goldstein misses the shot. Christian Charles with offensive rebound, but Kuatiwa takes it off him.
Quick hands from Kuatiwa there.
And Kuatiwa pulls another three. He's now 1 for 5.
Kuatiwa's gotten a bit cold after that shot. Gets a foul on Chris Charles here. Tua at all. Tua saying he hit him in the nose.
Tua was actually leaning forward towards Chris Charles.
Yeah, that's actually one thing I don't like about attempts for charge calls is that it rewards the defensive player for actually not attempting to play defense. Yeah. So it's a give or take kind of thing. Sometimes it's a good defensive play, but sometimes the players just give up and they get rewarded for it. Tua maybe a little bit of frustration there. Hopefully that's Steve Thomas.
Two quick fouls picked up by Kuatiwa. Goldstein pulls a three and gets it to go. Ready Goldstein from downtown.
10 points again. It's just a back and forth game here. See how Mono Harris respond to this. This quarter is that the Vampires haven't been able to get out on the fast break. They were able to get out on the break with Summer Jai and Solo. And those two guys are only able to stall down a little bit. This is Charles, this is a break here. Freddy Goldstein.
Freddy's gonna drive? No, passing it off.
Gasol again with the drive. Still in and out. Gasol was struggling to get that ball into the basket. With pretty impressive penetration guys here.
Yeah. Arnold's running for Gasol, but he's doing time screen control. Pull the rebound, so Arnold gets possession right now.
Halfway into the third quarter, we're going to see at the
as well with Mumboon, Summer Jai, Sorok, and Toveron, right?
Yeah, actually, two national team point guards, so that's a really deep decision that they have there. Sorok himself is pretty young, but he got the MVP of the Thailand basketball the last year, so that's not actually something to laugh about. It's a pretty deep position, but in the ABL, it's hard to get by at the point guard position with Mumboon, but Mono Vampire have been doing actually pretty well.
Especially if with a one-point guard in the game and a big two-guard is fine in the APL, but playing two small point guards is going to be a bit of a challenge, especially if you're going up against the likes of Matthew Wright, Tyler Lamb, with the other teams. David Arnold, he's going to be a bit undersized against these guys.
That's a good point, yeah. The Vampire loving those three-point shots.
This coach is very animated. Look at the fans a while ago right there. A lot of supporters in Thailand right now supporting both Thai teams. Come back to the ball game. With McLean, Okoli, Daron Pan, Toweroj, and Sorok for Mono Vampires. Tyler Lamb, Goldstein, at the Pornlet Malapone at the Twin Towers for High Tech Bangkok City. As coming off the break, High Tech gets a steal, and although Freddie Olsen gets a turnover by stepping out of bounds.
But maybe there's a 24-second violation call there. Seems like
yes, one referee is calling 24-second.
Mono Vampire events don't like that. Let's see what the call is. Refs gonna talk it out. But from what I see, is the ball wasn't actually in full possession of High Tech yet, so yeah, the shot clock should have kept running.
Yeah, Freddie didn't have full possession of the ball as he was chasing out of bounds.
He wasn't actually out of bounds, I think. That's not an out of bounds call either, but see what the refs decide with Apichok Sakho, the manager, hounding him right there.
He's just looking over the shoulder of the referee waiting for the decision.
That must be pressure. There with a duck.
So a traveling violation is called on Quincy Ogoli. He has been called for violations in the past games as well.
That's something that he has been working on his footwork off the ball. What happens here?
Drop pass.
Nice call by the refs.
Step first. Missed by Sorok Sultan Siri on that possession.
Happy Chok Sakho trying to get the foul onto Chris Charles there. See who gets it. It seemed like Freddie Goldstein was closer. We're going to see a replay. Not Chris Charles, is nowhere near there.
Chris Charles just stepped into the paint. So the foul is called and Freddie. That would have been Chris.
He has the pressure on the refs right
now. Trapped by Mono Vampires.
Nice play there.
Goldstein!
Nice way to break the press there from High Tech Bangkok City at the point with a nice long pass. Christian Charles has got a nice recognition of Freddie Goldstein. He just blasted the basket.
But Freddie Goldstein, being the quick guard that he is, just ran past all the defense.
Little Vampire putting in a lot of slashing players here, except the shooter. There's a big shot.
Gets the rebound, though. He's going to try another one.
Off the ball. Is it? Bit of what happened. Setting up the
both Lamb and Chris Charles have been taken out of the ballgame right now. We have Golgar, Dyson Hook.
Another three. Getting closer, but not quite there yet.
He's going to try another one. No, he fakes out.
Nice fake. Wide open shot. Wide open.
Probably hasn't warmed up yet. He was been sitting throughout the whole first half.
11-point lead here, but Christian Charles off the bench. Anything can happen.
Goldstein.
Got bodies on the floor. Four Mono Vampire players. Good recognition there.
Mono 50-39, 2 minutes, 25 seconds, correct that, 50-41. 9-point lead by High Tech Bangkok City. 25. Just joined us, folks. We have a very exciting matchup between High Tech Bangkok City and their rivals, Mono Vampires. High Tech up 9 points right now, 15-41. Fourth, making it home.
The Mono Vampires haven't had scored in double digits yet, so that means that there's a lot of points to be while. The High Tech Bangkok City only has 4 players scoring right now. Back to that, Tyler Lamb, Freddie Goldstein, Chris Charles. So let's see how that plays out. We're going to distribute the points and then we're getting the ball to the actual number of players.
Yes, as Coach Rahul Martella was mentioning during the halftime break, in the halftime interview, was that he wanted more point distribution with among his players.
So we're wide open here, he takes a three.
A bit short on that three. Mono retains possession. Good matchup right here, Klahan against Sukhdev Gogar.
Two strong guys. Oh, well, the speed there.
Freddie floater, but was a bit long.
Thomas, a wild pass there. He's got to be more careful there. Fully taking the jumper. That is not his shot at all. That's a shot that he likes to take, and it's not really been effective. I'm wondering why he takes so many shots.
Probably most effective when he's jumping in towards the ring rather than taking jump shots.
Steve Thomas can't find a basket as well. At the point with a lot of contact, Evan uncalled. Nice pass from Freddie Goldstein. That's got to be a goaltender. There's no way nobody can.
The referees are going to discuss it right now, but that was a foul on Steven Thomas. Count if it goes, if it's a goaltending.
That's a foul. That's a violation. That the refs have been on and off throughout the season. Sometimes they get it, sometimes they don't. But
see the replay over here.
That's a bad.
That should have been a goaltending because it hit the backboard already.
But one thing I've talked about other people about this is that the refs of the region are not actually that used to getting players who are athletic enough to actually get the puck out of the backboard. But they're gonna get used to it.
So they do count it. It's an end one for Chris Charles.
Get the ball. 12 points down with 1 minute left in the third quarter. See, they still have some life left in them. Okay, Bogart getting a lot of burn in this game.
Good steal by Steve Thomas. Tyson Nick.
An offensive foul on. Sarmak got position there, but once again, like I said, charging calls are rewarding for him, just giving up on the spot there. A lot of local players getting burned here. Shaiwat Gedam makes his way to the field.
Okoli! Okoli now!
Can't take advantage of the effort.
Put back dunk by Quincy Okoli!
Quincy Okoli please move on right on the spot, taking advantage of his athleticism there. Gotta push the ball up. Instantly calls an 8-second violation there. Good defense, good pressure from the Mono Vampires. and they will get the last possession here. 24 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter. Good luck, Hans, struggling, but of course, just plug him in the game. It's going to be a wild game.
Two turnovers there by Montana. Threw it away, although he hasn't warmed up yet. Look, pass. Able to be handled.
That's
a pretty big guy as well.
Really big guy. He has a really good mean streak. He's a good teammate. He protects his teammates. If he sees someone doing something wrong, he's going to get back. Another turnover by the Mono Vampires, and that's something that we've stressed out early in the game. Something that they've really been struggling with. It's starting to show here in the later stages of the game.
Yes, I agree with you with that, DK. Especially with Hitech committing turnovers, they're unable to capitalize on committing turnovers of their own.
Pretty long last 24 seconds of the game here. Hassan getting some advanced pressure, but makes his way to the basket.
Awesome! He gets a layup in. Contested as well.
And he's got to stop short right here.
Yeah, flying high.
Good way to finish the quarter on a high note there. Another additional 2 points for Hassan. Talking about something.
See, Tom is very animated. He's trying to clarify something with the referees.
Tries to get what he wants. It's hard to deny the guy of what he wants.
I take Bangkok City up 12 points to end the third quarter.
I want the time of my life. Yeah. Oh, baby.
Back to start the fourth quarter. Hitech up 12 points over Mono Vampires. Mono trying to get back into this ball game. They have 10 minutes left.
Right now, Mono Vampires have had only 17 turnovers. And if at this pace, they're going to go past their 22 turnovers from last game.
17 turnovers, that's a lot.
That's a lot. And there's one more there, Summer Jai.
18 turnovers.
A lot of locals for Hitech still on the court. Good to see that. So good, Gokar. That's on the good luck time. Steve Thompson, Tyler Lowe. And aggressive. Getting the foul on Dylan Klein, who doesn't like the call at all.
For a while now, both teams have been playing only one of their world imports each. Okoli and Stephen Thomas.
Nice pass there from Stephen Thomas from the high set up post. That was a good pass. Man, misses the first free throw. Not really been lights out from the free throw line. He's looking to get the ball for the post. Pressing up a little bit of time and there's a catalyst in the second quarter run. Chaiwat can't make the shot. Itek setting it up in the offense in the half court. Thomas getting Chaiwat get it's called for the hook. Might have extended a little bit further than the refs liked it. See that again.
If there was a local that could take Stephen Thomas's dishing, it's Chaiwat. He's a pretty big guy.
He takes the elbow in the neck there. It's a pretty solid call by the refs. The Vampires looking to get a basket in their first possession of the fourth quarter.
And a steal. Line. Take a slip off the pass. Oh, the pass is steal. Ruben.
Showing a lot of that there. Duncan finish at the basket, but
Tyler Lamb, technically that's his second dunk.
Let's just hope that they put him on the highlights just for that, even if it doesn't count. So missing the free throws.
Unable to extend the lead.
It's another area that Hightech has been struggling this season, but they've done pretty good this game actually. Gone 5-7 already. Zeke makes it. That's on Collins defense. Third quarter's best. But the guy from Wood coming into the game as a point guard. Still going to finish running for it. Samurjai weaving his way through the defense of Kuratiwa.
As soon as he steps in, takes that three.
It's a shooter, that's a shooter's mentality. Lakhan setting up the offense again. Doing a pretty solid job of putting that vision. Oka, that's his shot. Doesn't make it this time.
Who puts up the turbo, but Kuratiwa for three and gets it to go. Ratnak Kuratiwa.
Give him that much space. He's going to make it eventually. Even if he's been missing all night, just can't let him get into form.
His confidence will not go down despite the many misses he has had.
See Thomas working Chaiwat again.
Charles is first to get alongside Freddie Goldstein.
He's calling for a switch of defense there.
Tyler Lamb has to keep an eye on that Kuratiwa because he's going to attempt another one if he gets the ball.
Here we go again.
Right on cue. Kuratiwa for three. Doesn't get the friendly roll. Okoli slaps it away from Sukhdev Gogar. As the dead ball comes, we're going to have Christian Charles and Freddie Goldstein step back into the ball game.
Let's see if Coach Bressert will put Anthony McLean back in the game now that Chris Charles has made his way. But McLean has been really quiet this game, only 6 points and 10 rebounds. He's got a lot of rebounds, but that amount of 6 points is pretty concerning for the Golden Vampires.
And they need him to be more aggressive, more aggressive as well.
So Charles takes a shot.
A bit short there.
Good hustle from Steve Thomas to get Samurjai to
tap it out of bounds, yeah.
Jai is going to be subbed out. McLean makes his way back into the game, but they take Okoli out. Wilson back into the game as well. See you guys.
Back a bit short on that.
Follows around, Steve Thomas.
Charles
gets it. Thomas to finish now. Here. Something.
Once again, no!
Thomas is going
Thomas,
in.
Yes!
Finally, Steve Thomas finishes the possession for Hightech.
Steve and Thomas and Chris Charles both working at it.
gotta love the hustle from the team, but you gotta also be concerned about the finishing there. Chai Watt makes easy possession there, 2 points, mid-range jumper.
That's Chai Watt's advantage over Okoli. He has that mid-range shot.
That's why he's on the court right now. 6 minutes left in the fourth quarter. High Tech still up by 13 points. Do Mono Vampire still have a run left in them?
If they do, they have to start now. One stop at a time.
Lasso trying to get in there. Once again, he makes his way to the basket. And a shot clock violation. Too much dribbling there.
Somebody should have signaled Gutapang Dasam. Usually that's a point guard's job.
Gonna have to try it out again. Pretty good defense there to pressure Ruben to not be focused on the shot clock. And Mono's gonna set it up. Try to get closer to the High Tech lead. Tiwa
gets open. And gets it to go.
Tiwa starting to fire up. See if they can keep it going.
That was over the extended arms of Chris Charles as well.
Tiwa already hit his third three in the game. It's taken him 10 attempts. Lamb, see if he can respond.
Lamb answers back.
Lamb just with a full 3-point shoot.
Lamb was open with that possession because Anthony McLean didn't step out to challenge him.
What I'm looking forward to here is Tiwa getting the ball and getting right back in Lamb's face.
Although they go down to Anthony McLean, but turnover is committed.
Michok Sackho maybe losing some energy from the early animated cheering there early on. Will the Vampires get the ball at the baseline? Chai Watt Gedam gets Kurtiwa off the curl.
Good double team by High Tech to prevent the three.
Chai Watt has Freddie Goldstein on him.
Chai Watt didn't see Tori Rodger in the corner open. Goldstein pulls up the speed.
Dangerous play there for good, both players, actually.
Good intention by Goldstein, but Lamb wasn't unable to control the pass. Good thing both players are safe and okay. That's what's important.
I'm liking what I see from the High Tech here. They're running out there. They're starting to enjoy what they're doing, enjoy their play. It's really just satisfying to see the players going out there and enjoying their craft.
Well, basketball should be enjoyed. Players play their best when they're having fun. And we have a timeout right now. So let's see what adjustments Mono Vampire has to make to try and make a run against High Tech Bangkok City. Coming out from the timeout right now, High Tech has possession on the baseline.
Yeah, but they get the ball back in. Goldstein setting up the offense. It's a screen up top. They'll use it. I love with the quick hedge.
What a crossover by Goldstein.
Goldstein doesn't get it, but almost.
That was a beautiful crossover by Freddie Goldstein, although he wasn't able to get the friendly roll with a layup.
Might get the possession here with Chai Watt seeming to get the loose ball foul.
I see the replay.
What a move there. Nice way to use his body to block.
also is the timing of the bounce of the ring. That's why Chai Watt was called for the foul there.
One of the vampires pushing the ball up.
But what a block by Christian Charles. And a steal!
Somehow the Mono Vampires get the ball there. Sloppy playing here from High Tech. Don't want to end the game this way. High Tech still with a 10-point lead. It's 4 minutes left in the game. Still plenty of time to make a run back. High Tech trying to make sure that they get this possession. Just jogged with the mid-range there. Gets Steve Thomas inside.
Steve Thomas draws a foul, but is unable to get the shot down.
I think this change in the second half has been the aggressiveness of High Tech going inside and getting those fouls. It's really benefited them. Sorry about
from the zero output on the free throw line in the first half to being able to draw a couple of fouls in the second half. So good adjustment made by the coaches of High Tech Bangkok City. To stay aggressive inside. Although Stephen Thomas misses the first free throw.
Thomas gets one in to push the lead to 12. See if he can stay within double digits or the Mono Vampires can hit a three to make it only single. Vampires setting it up. Toros seeing a lot of minutes here in this game. Frederick Goldstein with the hustle there. You get the ball. And it seems like there's a kickball on someone. Goldstein with a lot of hustle here. I'm loving what I see from him.
I agree with you. Not afraid to sacrifice his body. Diving into the floor. Look at this possession.
Yeah, good call by the refs. Freddie Goldstein caught a bit of the ball on his foot. Good hustle from him nonetheless.
And the timeout is called once again. So let's listen in to Coach Sang of Mono Vampires.
Intensity that both teams are showing here.
See both sides cheering their hearts out for their teams. And Wong Boon gets open for three but misses.
Would have been a huge shot here, and Steve Thomas with the rebound. Stall Steve Thomas a little bit frustrated there in the timeout. I think that was the pass that led to the open basket. The kind of player Steve is, he doesn't like the little things that he misses out. Goldstein with a nice step.
Steve was a real leader.
Tyler Lamb with the ball here. 3 minutes left, and Tyler Lamb's been playing a really good game here. The game to keep the success is the way. I think he should. Dolan Ross with the three. Still can't find his mark. And the three-point shooting has been a problem for the Mono Vampires this game. They've taken almost 20 shots. They only made a few of the marks from Rutgers Cortiva. Ball flops around. High-tech ball.
Mono Vampires has a lot of shooters in their team, but unable to capitalize downtown throughout the whole ball game. As you mentioned, only Cortiva has made three-point shots.
I was talking earlier about Tyler Levin, how he's played pretty well in this game. What do you think about that, Joe?
Actually, I think the entire lineup has been doing a great job.
Getting up a bit slow. I don't know if he's injured there. Took a huge fall there from the two players. Seems to land a bit awkwardly on his left foot. Can't see him on screen right now. High Tech has a commanding 15-point lead with only 2 minutes left. I think it would be safe for Coach Jimmy to just take him out. Interestingly, we haven't seen much of Bert Lanko in this game. Coach Jing, well, Coach Jing has been doing a lot of things to him. We're going to see some substitutions here. Samar Jai making his way back into the court. Samar Jai has actually been shooting really good before this game. He's been shooting around 50% from the field, but hasn't showed that range in this game. Charles, great guy.
Freddie Goldstein in the ball game.
Seems to be running okay. Taking on the break.
Christian Charles with a mid-range shot.
Pushes the lead up to 16, and with 2 minutes left, that's a pretty big lead. Samar Jai with a flashy play there.
A good steal by Tyler Lamb. He's going to pull up for three. In and out.
That would have brought the house down.
And would have sealed the coffin of the vampires as well.
Sealed the coffin, dude. There, Joe. Foul there on Chai Wat. Samar Jai looking for a way to approach this defense that really struggles.
The Vampire is not utilizing most of their
points. I like how High Tech have been approaching the pick and rolls. They're getting their inside players to high top point guards up early, making them get those turnovers that they've been really struggling on here. Samar Jai for three, can't hit. Another possession for High Tech. It's pretty much a done deal at this point.
That's right, TK with a minute 19 to go, 17-54. High Tech Bancroft City still up. Although Dossum almost loses it.
10 seconds left. Christian Charles trying to work it.
Thought we were gonna see a pull-up three by Chris Charles.
That would have been good to see.
Lamb again with a steal. Cortivo looked frustrated on that.
Well, the Vampires had any chance. It pretty much went away with that throwaway pass.
So with 1 minute left.
It's
70-54.
Staying there in disbelief of that pass. Again, I feel like the Vampires haven't actually been playing that bad of a game, other than one aspect of the game that's been troubling them all season, with turnovers. It's been really struggling for the point guards to get the ball anywhere. And they got away with the game, the win last game, but here, not the same situation.
You accompany that with the hunger of High Tech Bancroft City to try and get a win coming off that loss against Singapore Slingers in their home court. So this is the result that you get. 71-54, minute left. Man, trying to push the lead. Gets it. 72-54.
Than before. Both teams have games on this weekend. So High Tech will be playing the Saigon Heat on Saturday, and the Mono Vampires will be playing the KL Dragons on Sunday. So I expect that at this point, maybe the teams might be looking forward to those games in advance and maybe want to rest their more important players.
Especially High Tech Bangkok City, I'm pretty sure. You know, these couple of days approaching the weekend should benefit them.
Yep, they're gonna have to take their rest really seriously. Seems like we might be seeing Chanatip Jakawan making a debut here.
recovers and gets the three right on cue when we were talking about if Tyler Lamb should be the player of the ball game. And I guess that one just reassures it. So let's see what Taco has in store for us as Gogar is in. Makan, Jacrowan, Pirun. There you go, folks, number 31. Trying to tip Jacrowan, the new addition, the youngster from High Tech Bangkok City, playing the center position.
Pirun firing up the youngster for his debut. Of course, he would know what it takes to be in the ABL game, the veteran.
And Gogar fouls Okoli. I think Tyler Lamb has been showing a really good output once again, TK, right?
Yeah, he's been sitting. He's just been sent to the bench, but he's been really playing a good game as well. And here's Okoli with the free throws. Not a happy face there on the Mono Vampire bench. But they have room for improvement. It's not a bad. It's still only the seventh game of the season. There's more than half of the season left. They do a lot more with the lineup that they have. Foul down low.
Jacrowan called. Stuffs his stat sheet there. One foul.
Not the best way to get on the stat sheet there.
Instead of getting a one rebound, he gets that one foul. Pushing off Kruotiwa.
Gets Kruotiwa to the line. The timeout called here again by the High Tech Bangkok City team. Maybe gonna try to get Chanathip Chakrawan some touches on the offensive side. Get some time for him after that foul.
And that would be a good move by Coach Jimmy Ruiz if he could draw up a play for either Chakrawan or any of the locals. Let's see what Coach Jing Ruiz has drawn up for his team.
Wide here in the open court. That did not count before.
Oh, the Vampire committing the foul. I don't understand why they're committing the foul right now. They're down by points. I don't think they're going to be able to catch up pretty much.
But there's still time. There's still hope, Joe.
Well, unless you got Tracy McGrady in your team, as I always say.
Interesting that Coach Jing Ruiz hasn't put in Ganawat Nerdakul into the game, even with a blowout. Right? Mm-hmm.
Good point there, TK.
Two out of two. Stand another timeout call. One of the longest minute in the ABL here. Timeouts called, fouls called.
With the timeouts and fouls called, you think it's a one-point game. I guess they just love to play the game of basketball, trying to delay the game so much as they can.
Okay.
I want to consume that time. 55 seconds. Much
better. You can see in that clip right there, just showing the high tech, the bench, the veterans talking and trying to pump up the new addition to the squad, the rookie, Jack Rowan.
Yeah, that's what I love. What I love that that part of it, that they're trying to really get him confidence, get him the experience of playing. It's gonna do wonders for the lot of the season. We're looking for in the Mono Vampire inbound, probably a quick 3-point shot. There we go. No, we don't.
Well, Boone gets loose.
And we get a quick two.
See Mono Vampire to foul. High tech players, there they have it. Committed on Sukhdev Gogar.
Gogar has only timeouts left.
39 seconds to go.
Seems to be some dispute about the clock running. What I know, in the fourth quarter, the last 2 minutes, they've got to stop the clock
yes.
at every dead ball. So. See if the refs wind up the clock over there, so he'll be running after that shot from Metakan. They're gonna stand at the line already.
Do you think Mono Vampire still has a chance to take this victory?
Well, if Krotiwa can get the ball and he can just fire it out, maybe they can make it interesting in the final 20 seconds.
Krotiwa giving a word of encouragement to Sukhdev Gogar as he was waiting in the free throw line.
Five seconds left. Missing.
Just the game clock right now.
That's going to be an issue that's going to be discussed later. You can see the men's there talking to the refs.
At this point of the game, with less than a minute to go, every second counts, folks. Every second counts. Even milliseconds count. Let's see what final decision they make.
Probably doesn't want that going on. He doesn't need those extra seconds anyway.
Rah just wants the game to end right now. Krotiwa giving Sukhdev a massage. He just took sportsmanship to a whole new level.
Putting some pressure on the young sir, maybe. So friendly jogging back and forth there. He wants to put some points on the score sheet here under his name.
That's good to see the camaraderie that these two teams have, especially the local players. Despite being, you know, cross-country rivals on the court, off the court, they're actually really good friends. Well, yeah. Most of them, at least.
That's always fun.
And Gogar misses the first.
Jayo's taking credit for that massage, for the missed shot. See if they can get a rebound if the shot misses.
Gogar makes a second one.
15-point game. See if they can pull a quick three and make it slightly a little bit interesting. Taking more time here for sure.
Mono taking a lot of time. High tech.
Someone should take the shot.
Just
right.
Taking a quick two.
More points.
Mono Vampires took too long that possession. Vicious got in quick two, got in the lane, hopefully get a foul.
Nice.
Instead, they ended up with a fadeaway 3-point by Samajai that only hit the back.
There's some hope there for a second point.
Fans of High Tech cheering him on. Gogar goes 2 out of 2. from the strike. Nonetheless, he gets fouled, and two free throws for Bandit Lacan.
I think maybe someone fouled out here. Nope, everyone seems to be staying on the court. Oh, no, someone's picked up the fifth foul. So we gotta make a decision here.
Someone's got a foul on the ball.
Tyler Harris called Happy Birthday, 5-5. In the Philippines, from what I know, it's called graduating, right?
Yeah, Joe? You graduate off the game.
It's actually a fun way to call it. There's someone talking around here. Not sure what is in discussion. Able to take a look at this if it is possibly the longest 1 minute video history ever.
Yeah, as you mentioned a while ago, right before the minute started.
Is he warming down already? It's still 15 seconds. Get up.
He's doing some end game stretches.
Get up, man.
This is a very interesting 1 minute segment until the end of the ball game. As Lacan misses, but wow, Jack Rowan tries to get back. He has some hops. Rodiwa backs it in.
Still has some life in him. Like I said, a little too late here. 12 points, 8 seconds. He's going to take a miracle.
That's a look.
Yopong Hiro, pass it to the young guy. Somebody hit Jack Rowan. Nobody's going to get him, and the game's going to end.
That was a good matchup. Good game, pretty much, although towards that last 1 minute, dragged out a bit too long, 77-65.
Coach is embracing a bit there, celebrating a bit, maybe giving them some cheers for the next games, heading up in the weekend. I see a lot of smiles there.
It's good to see the camaraderie between the two teams, as I mentioned a while ago. Inside the court, they are rivals, but outside, as soon as the game is over, all smiles, hugs, and great sportsmanship shown by both players, both teams, along with the coaching staff as well.
Yeah, it was a good game of basketball. I really liked the game. There was nothing chippy, nothing, no bad intentions from both teams. They were just playing straight up basketball. In the end, somebody has to win, but I think the crowd got a really good game out of this.
Oh yes, I agree with you, TK. And especially, I guess the big winner here are the Thai fans.
Yeah, we had a really good game. And it's sad to say that there's only two more left of this matchup left between these two teams, but the remaining games will be played at the Mono Vampire Stadium.
So the new stadium.
The new
Vampire,
stadium.
Right?
So they're going to High Tech has got to enjoy all of this while they can. So let's go to Victoria with her interview with the player of the game, Tyler Lam.
It was a very exciting game from two teams, but finally High Tech won the World Mono Vampire by 12 points. And the best player for this match is Tyler Lam. Okay, sawadee-ka. Congratulations again. Okay, how do you feel that you're back on track and get one in this match? How do you feel about your performance?
Well, after last game, you know, I played very bad last game for myself. You know, I felt like I didn't play up to the standards at all. So I just got back in the gym and just kept shooting jumpers and working on my game, and it just showed tonight. You know, I knocked down some jumpers early, and it got us in a flow offensively, and I carried it to the second half. And my teammates did a great job of finding me open shots, and I was just able to knock them down tonight.
Okay, so now you can recover, right?
Yeah. I feel good right now, but we got to focus on the next game. We got a pretty big game next game also.
Okay, how is your readiness for the next game coming?
Well, I mean, I'll be in the gym tomorrow, and I'll be in the gym, I mean, every day now until our games, because, I mean, that's what it takes. It's getting to the middle of the league now, and now we're going to have to start knocking down jumpers because teams are knowing our plays. You know, we played every team almost once except for Malaysia. So teams are going to know our plays, and now it's just a matter of being able to knock down shots late in the game.
Okay, let's talk to your fan.
Well, thanks for supporting me, and hope to see you guys next game. And
okay, thank you so much. Thank you for watching, and see you the next week. Bye.
Thank you for that interview, Victoria. Tanner Lamb speaking a bit of Thai there. Well, folks, that was an amazing ball game and an amazing output by High Tech Bangkok City. And one word for Tyler Lamb, redemption.
That was good redemption. He just got back. He showed athleticism that he hadn't showed before in the ABL with those two dunks. And he shot 3 for 6 from three-point line, something that he didn't obviously make in the game against the Slingers. It was a really good game for him. It's good to see that he's got his stroke back.
Yes, definitely. And as Tyler Lamb mentioned, even without Division One going on, there are still no days off for High Tech Bangkok City and their players working on for and preparing for the next games that they are going to have. So, well, once again, my name is Joe Giao, and my co-commentator today, Sajitam Kulsom Boon, also known as TK, our basketball analyst. Thank you very much for all your support, and I hope you enjoy the game. Thank you and goodbye.
Things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block. You might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be. But everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small, and now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena. It's fun.
Make your own way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, not a follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life, you know. So I've been there before and I get it.